Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. It's 2:20 p.m. Central Time on the 19th of September 2022. Got breaking news for everybody. An extremely large earthquake has now struck in Central America off the coast of Mexico. 7.6 magnitude. This is the exact magnitude we had warned for the East Pacific. If you didn't know that I had issued a warning for the East Pacific, please jump over and check my other videos over on YouTube over this past week. The reason we issued a warning for a 7.6 earthquake, 7.5 to 7.6, to strike in the East Pacific was the combined total of all the 7.0 level activity over in the West Pacific adding up to 7.5 to 7.6. Mexico has a tsunami warning issued at the moment, and if we jump over and check the USGS tsunami warning information page, which is tsunami.gov, you'll see they have it listed as a threat, and then they have it listed right here, 1 to 3 meters in Mexico, issued at 2:07:44. Again, that's, local time, but this all happened within the last hour. Now, we could go over and check the National Data Buoy Center, NDBC, buoys. And the National Data Buoy Center, it might be swamped right now for us to try to get information from it. I don't know. We'll see how quick it loads. Ah, okay. We already have a tsunami buoy in motion. And we have a hurricane over the location, which many people might not know about the connection between large storms and earthquakes. There is a connection, definitely. We see large earthquakes develop out below big storm systems in many cases, especially tropical systems. Now there's a friction action, electron cascade, and some other things that are taking place there. The differential between the storm and the charge in the ground, and that brings us to earthquake activity by storms. But here's our event mode for the wave. And yeah, I mean, even out there, it looks like we're getting about a quarter of a meter of rise and fall on one buoy so far, and that's out there flashing in the ocean. You see which way the tropical system is forecast to go, but I mean, they are right next to each other. Cannot ignore that. Now, going back over to the earthquake information from the USGS, the depth on this 15 kilometers deep, and it is right along the coast. I mean, that's why they have the tsunami warning issued, even though it was on land. This is an example of a tsunami happening out in the ocean, even though the earthquake happens on land, which I was actually told by people just a few months ago was impossible. I don't know who told me that, but some professionals told me it was impossible for a tsunami to be generated if an earthquake strikes on land. And I had to take the fallacy on that and just tell everybody that was not correct. But anyway, that was a few weeks back when an earthquake struck on land, when the 7.6 struck on land across over in the ocean. Over next to Papua New Guinea, not in the ocean. And they said that there would be no tsunami in the ocean from the big earthquake on land over here at Papua New Guinea. And they said it was impossible. And I had to take people to task for that, because it is totally possible for the plate boundary to move even though you have an earthquake on land next to it. Now, the plate boundary is obviously seen here in the folds in the plate right off the coast. The location in question. We have Colima volcano up to the north, and I have not seen Colima on the list at all in months, if not years. We can go check the Volcanic Ash Advisory Center and see what it shows, just to see if it's on there, but I'm looking for Mexico, and we'll probably only see Popocatépetl, which is right next to Mexico City. And what I would like to do is just see if there are any other big blasts that are taking place or anything else worth noting. Catovar, for instance, in the West Pacific. Okay, so we have one volcano in Central America going right now. That's pretty low in comparison to where we've been in the past. So let me just remind everybody, we're now dealing with a 7.6 in the East Pacific. After we had a 7.6 in the West Pacific, no more than 7 days ago. Also, subsequent 7.0 level activity in Taiwan, 7.0 level activity. Here at New Caledonia and the 7.6 right in the middle here. Last week, we had a 6.6 to near 7.0 earthquake in China, caused devastating damage. A lot of people were injured. And the week before that, 2 weeks ago, we had a 7.0 here, right on the letter X, right next to it, out in the mid-Atlantic Ridge. When that 7 hit, you can go watch my video. We were talking about the planet spreading on both sides of the planet and to expect stuff like this to take place. So two 7.6s, both sides of the plates. Over on my YouTube channel, I've got a few videos out over the past several days where I talked about the tennis match that happens back and forth when we get large earthquake activity like this. It seems to be, the threshold seems to be about the mid-range 7 level for this to happen. And we've seen this happen before. Give you an example. We saw a mid-range 7 strike here at Kyushu, and the next day, a mid-range 7 struck over here at Ecuador. Then the next day, a 7-point-something earthquake struck here at New Caledonia going into Solomon Islands. Then the next day, off the coast of Mexico. It was 4 days in a row almost, or maybe five, where 7s bounced back and forth, and that was just one example that I used in my broadcast this past week. And now, here we are, mid-range 7s on both sides of the plate again. So what happens here is compensation. Compensation starts to take place, or a back and forth starts to take place on the plate boundary. And let me just show you the plate boundary here really quick on the USGS plate boundary map, if it even loads. Yeah, here we go. So plate boundary map shows it to us, the thick red lines here going all the way around the Pacific, for instance, and across over even to Europe and all the way out across the United States and Central and South America. Well, we've got big activity over here in the West Pacific over the past several days, going into last week, 7.6 at Papua New Guinea, going into Solomon Islands, 7.0 at New Caledonia, 7.0 up here at Taiwan, 6.6 to 7 over in China. That's all in the past few days going into last week, which prompted me to issue the warning in the East Pacific from everywhere from Chile all the way up into Central America. Now, I don't think we're done yet. I think we're going to see this down south in South America. I'm not canceling the warning for Chile. I had issued a warning for Chile for this exact magnitude going up into Central America. I brought up the possibility of Mexico, and I said if I was wrong, it was going to strike up north in Central America. Well, looks like I was wrong, quote unquote, for now. And it struck on the north side. Again, it's a 50-50, and let me show you what I'm talking about. It literally is a matter of a 50-50 split coming off the West Pacific, going to the north. You see it? The big arrow and the big arrow pointing south. My warning down here to the south, I am not expiring at all. I'm not canceling it all the way around it, and I mean quite literally all the way around it. We've got ourselves noteworthy activity taking place. Let's also mention the 6.0 earthquake, somewhat rare, striking down here in the South Indian Ocean, next to the letter X, fracture zone to the south. Now the USGS has it listed at 5.6. A subsequent 6 has now struck. So a subsequent 6. These are antipodes of one another. This, if you look through the planet, to the opposite side, that's where our 7.6 is. So we have a 6 on one side of the planet and a 7.6 on the other. Sound familiar? It happened just no more than 2 weeks ago. We had a 6 right here, and we go through the planet, and our rare 7 struck out here on the mid-Atlantic Ridge, prompting me to tell the whole planet that the whole planet's moving and to be ready for large earthquake activity. So I think I need to save this now 100%. We've got buoys in event mode. We've got a 1 to 3 meter tsunami, and 3 meter is going to be 10 feet tall. 9 feet tall. So that would be a big deal if it was 3 meters. If it's 1 meter, people might not notice as much. It still could come in and cause damage. But, I mean, we're talking about it would be arriving right about now. It takes about 30 minutes, an hour, so forth, for wave activity to be generated and come into land. It's about the speed of an airliner that the tsunami would be moving at. So that's a big deal. This really is a big deal, guys. And I told you it would be a big deal. I'm not bragging, but I have to tell you that I told you, because no one else is going to tell you that I told you. unless you know somebody who watches. And the reason is, of course, well, multifold. We've got a lot of resistance from the professionals on everything that we've found so far, because it contradicts a lot of what was said to be possible. If you're over in Europe, if you're in the Mideast, if you're on the west coast of the United States, if you're on the west coast of South America, Chile, Peru, Colombia, west coast U.S., obviously California, Oregon, Washington, Canada too. Look, guys, we're getting compensation on both sides of the plate. We have to look between our current sets of earthquakes, large earthquakes, to find where the next spots to be struck are. And just looking at it overall right now, I mean, this 7.6 came rolling in between the previous earthquakes that struck. You can see them marked in red. And we can look off the west coast of the United States to see that there's a spot where there's two earthquakes to three, where their rings overlap. Well, we have right down at the U.S. border with Mexico. And then we have right here along the border of California and Oregon. I mean, that's a big deal. We're going to have to watch both spots. Both of them should get hit by something at least a magnitude larger than where we are now. U.S. sitting high and dry, I don't like that. Not with this going on. And I don't like Chile sitting high and dry either with this going on. So this is the magnitude we were looking for, and this is the East Pacific earthquake we were looking for. But I don't think we're done yet. I think we're going to go down south too, down to the previous warned area in Chile. So if you were looking for our mid-range 7, you can certainly check it off the list. And if you're looking for a compensation earthquake, you can certainly check it off the list. If you're looking for me to get it down to 200 miles on this one, not happening. Now, on the East Pacific warning, I'm very pleased with that. This is something that we can start to forecast on based upon just on mid-range 7 bouncing back and forth on both sides of the Pacific plate. It helps to know if an earthquake's going to strike in the East Pacific versus the West Pacific. I mean, it helps to know. It's better than just being completely blind flying through the darkness here, that we knew to expect this in the East Pacific this week now. And the reason being, of course, compensation that happens on both sides of the plate. Do you have an earthquake plan? The people over in Taiwan, look, they're earthquake ready over in the West Pacific, over in Japan and Taiwan. You can go watch the videos of the damage of the 7.0 earthquake that just hit yesterday over in Taiwan and see how the people who are prepared still had major problems. And I would encourage you guys all to just think about it. What would you do if a big earthquake hit? Do you have the emergency supplies? Do you have the stuff taken care of? Do you even know your surroundings well enough? Do you know whether you should take shelter inside your building or should you go outside? Now, it's going to be a big if you're going to go outside, because you might be running into a worse situation than what's inside. And it's much better to take shelter underneath a table or a desk than to try to run around and avoid falling objects. But if you're not confident in the structure that you're in, you're in a stone stack structure or a cinder block building of some kind of warehouse you work at during the day or something, big tall walls that are stacked stone, well, you might need to have an exit plan. And if you have an exit plan, you need to know where you're going outside. And I'm serious. You need to know what's around you, power lines, sewer lines, gas lines, things that can fall off buildings, even trees in some cases. Okay, let's get this saved up and put over onto YouTube immediately so everybody can see it. One more time, 7.6 earthquake striking on the coast of Mexico on land, but we have a 1 to 3 meter tsunami warning issued. Not a watch, a warning. Warning means most likely imminent. It's just like the weather. If you, difference between a watch is just you're kind of watching out for it, and the warning means the storm is already formed. That's where we are now. Pacific has gone into insane overdrive over the past several days, this past week. You can watch my videos amp up from the point where that 7 hit out in the Mid-Atlantic Ridge 2 weeks ago to now. So, proof positive that earthquakes can be forecast down to a region, down to a time within a few days, and certainly down to within a magnitude. You guys be safe. Word up, much love. Don't be scared. Please, do not be scared. You need to be prepared. And being prepared just means knowing what to do when an earthquake strikes. Kind of takes the mystery out of it. Word up.